Hey, it's Shep Hyken here, customer service and experience expert, with live commentary on what's happening with Amazon acquiring Whole Foods. Now, I'm a huge Whole Foods fan. I am also a huge Amazon fan. Love what Amazon has done. I can go on and on. I think that I hate to use the word cliche because sometimes cliche is a negative. Has a negative connotation, but I think that when it comes to amazing companies doing amazing things, as being the most innovative companies that they could possibly be, I think that Amazon may be the leader as far as that goes. Now let's talk about Whole Foods. Whole Foods is a retailer. Hey, the last I don't know how many number of quarters has not been doing that well. They've had negative results, but you know what? That doesn't mean they're not a great company. Everything they do is focused on the customer, similar to Jeff Bezos. Whole philosophy that everything is about the customer. And if you look at the organic foods, the fresh foods, everything that Whole Foods puts out there, the focus is we want to give quality, quality, quality. Now, quality comes at a price because of the joke is Whole Foods means whole paycheck. But come on now, does it really? I mean, quality is remembered long after price is forgotten. And how much more expensive is Whole Foods than your typical grocer? Well, the answer is actually a bit more, to the point where some people would say, you know what, it's not affordable or it's not worth it. But here's my point. It's a quality organization. Now, why would Amazon buy a higher end company when they're known for great selection and lower prices? So let's take a look at the Amazon model over the years, how it's changed. It has been known for low, low prices, if not even the best price. And they want to be competitive. But they're so comfortable with their proposition of creating really a positive, I would call a competitive price, that they're willing to say, if you go on Amazon, they're actually showing you, hey, you can buy this less money somewhere else. Here's the link to that retailer. And it's your choice. Now, how much less is it? It's not always that much less. So like I say, Amazon remains competitive. So why Whole Foods? Well, number one, quality organization, totally focused on the customer. That's probably one of the number one reasons. Number two, locations. I believe my research says that Whole Foods has over 400 locations. That means that Amazon now potentially has 400 distribution centers for fresh food delivered to the consumer directly. And that's really what Amazon's getting into. Amazon is an amazing delivery service. Today with Prime membership, almost everything you buy can get to you within 2 days. And in some markets, they're promoting same day delivery and many times within 2 hours. How do you compete with a company like this? Well, there's lots of companies out there creating amazing conveniences for their customers. Amazon probably represents virtually any area of convenience as possible. Location, now they have physical locations. In other words, warehouses and distribution centers in many major markets, so that they're literally within same day delivery range of virtually any and every customer. And if you think about Walmart, the stat that I love is that 9 out of 10 people live within, I think, 15 minutes or 10 miles of a Walmart. I mean, that's pretty amazing. That's location. So Amazon's now moving into location. With physical stores like Whole Foods, they're getting into location, but they're also getting into a better distribution system. So here's my take on it, and I'll wrap all this up. Amazon is an amazing company. Whole Foods is amazing. Love them both. You put them together, and guess what? The grocery industry is going to change. So, people out there that are worried about being disrupted that are in this industry, get used to it. It's going to be a change. It's not that they're going to disrupt us. I think they're going to raise the bar, and we're going to have to meet and understand what Amazon is doing to become as competitive or competitive in different ways than what Amazon's doing. And the grocery industry, as I mentioned, is going to change. And you know the biggest beneficiary? It's us, the customers. So thanks for watching. This is Shep Hyken. Hope you enjoyed this short commentary. And I'd like to remind you, until next time, to always be amazing.